Yes, hi everyone. Welcome back to Power Systems 2 online series. As in the previous class, we completed the third unit, that is the performance of long transmission line. And today, let us start the next unit, that is the fourth unit. The title of the unit is Transients in Power Systems. Transients in Power System. The transients in power system. Yes, basically, what do you mean by transient? Do you have any idea? I hope all of you are studied in your electrical circuits analysis. Electrical circuit analysis 2. Yes, in that subject you have the transients in power, transients in electrical circuit. The same concept here also we used. Yes, before going to the concept, so first let me introduce about the transient. Yes, what do you mean by transients? Yes, a transient in the sense the behavior of the system when the system is subjected to the sudden change. Yes, what is the meaning of sudden change? Suppose for example, in your street there are so many houses are there. So let us assume that is one power system. In that power system, if any house, of course in your house, and if you turn on the AC, then what happened? Suddenly you are giving some load to the transformer. Therefore, in with respect to the transformer, your load is transient in the system. Okay, like that. So that means the load may be connected suddenly or load may be disconnected suddenly. That can be treated as the transient. Okay, so and it may not be present long time. And this is one aspect of the transient, just this is one example like that I am giving. And in most cases, what is the transient in the sense? The transients in the sense when the switch is open and switch is closed. Suppose for example, this is our power system. This is the power system. So here I am giving the supply. Power system in the sense anything. And it is connected through the switch. Let it be switch is yes. Now let us assume the switch is closed at t is equal to 0. Then the behavior of the power system at t is equal to 0 plus is considered as transient behavior. What is the meaning of 0 plus? 0 plus indicates immediately after closing the switch. The behavior of the system is called transient behavior. Or t is equal to 0 minus. In the sense it is immediately, that is before closing the switch. So this is considered as transient. And we can also take a t is equal to infinity. In the sense steady state operation of the system. Therefore, for any system, there are two responses are there. Those are, the first one is transient response. And And second one is steady state response. Steady state response. Yeah, the two responses for the system is, first one is transient response, which is also called dynamic response. Transient response or dynamic response, and steady state response. So all these things we studied in our electrical cycles. And today, how we analyze the power system in transient response, that is the transients in power system. So let me introduce this concept. Okay. Yes, what is transient response, or what do you mean by transients? Yes, the transient phenomenon is an aperiodic function of time. Aperiodic function of time. So there is no specific function for the transient phenomenon, and it cannot be live long. So the duration of the transient is very short. The duration of the transient is very short when it is compared with the operating time of the system. Okay, so even though the duration is very short, but it is required to remember the it is required to give the importance to the transients, because so based on the severity, because the transients may cause to block out the city, or transients may cause to shut down the entire electric plant. The transients may cause to give the fire in the some buildings. So such severity is there. So as severity is there for the transients, and based on the severity, we need to give importance to the transients. Just write the three lines. I will dictate this. Yes, keep writing. Introduction. Yes, write in that. The transients phenomenon. Transients phenomenon is an aperiodic function. Aperiodic function of time. Aperiodic function of time. And does not last longer. Just to do remember as it is, that is, transients phenomenon is an aperiodic function of time and does not last longer. Yes, full stop. And how much duration these transients will exist? Just write it. The duration for which they last is very insignificant. Insignificant as compared with the operating time of the system. Operating time of the system. Yes. Yes, now the question is, if it is so, then why we are giving importance to the transients? If it is so, then why we are giving importance to the transients? Because it may black out in city. It may black out in city. Black out in a city. And it may shut down electric plant. Shut down of a plant. And fires in some buildings. Fires in some buildings. Yes, fires in some buildings, in the sense, this kind of fire may cause to damage the ACs or refrigerators or coolers or whatever the electrical appliances are there that may be damaged due to this. So there are three important things are there in the transients. So hence, so we need to we need to give importance to the transients. Just write on that. Yet they are very important. Yet they are very important because depending upon the severity of these transients, the system may result into blackout in a city. Yes, you see on the screen, blackout in a city, comma, shutdown of a plant, and fires in some buildings, etc. Yes. And if you see the power system can be considered as made up of linear impedance elements of resistance, inductance and capacitance. The circuit is normally energized and carries load until a fault suddenly occurs. The fault then corresponds to the closing of a switch or switches, depending upon the type of fault in the electrical cycle. The closing of the switch changes the circuit so that a new distribution of currents and voltages is brought about. The redistribution is accompanied in general by a transient period during which the resultant current and voltages may momentarily be relatively high. It is very important to realize that this redistribution of currents and voltages cannot take place instantaneously. Yes, what is this meaning? In the sense, the power system, in the sense, the entire power system contains or can viewed with three elements only. Those three elements are resistance, inductance and capacitance. And moreover, these three elements performance can viewed with voltage and current. Yes. Next one is, now we the circuit, that is the power system, that is resistance, inductance, capacitance, so normally excited or energized and carried the load. The load is connected to the source in the power system until the fault suddenly occurs. That means, if suppose this is power system, in the power system the source is there and load is there, these two are connected continuously and these two are disconnected. Whenever the fault occurs, then load may be disconnected from the source. Okay, so then what we do? Yes, we can do either, yes, we can close the switch or we can open the switch. or we can connect so many switches, therefore so many switches will be operated in the electrical switch. So hence, whenever the switches are closing or opening, so then there is a chance of changing the values of voltage and current. Then there is the chance of changing the values of voltage and current. So now the distribution of current and voltages are changed, which is to be considered as the redistribution of voltage and currents. Redistribution of voltage and current during this transient. During this transient. And here we can assume that, yes, we can consider that this voltage and current may be changing instantaneously. Instantaneously in the sense without change in time. Is it possible to change the voltage and the current in the power system? Just to think, in the power system, is it possible to change voltage and current? Yes, it is not possible. So what we say in the sense, in the power system, voltage and current changes gradually. It is not instantaneously. It is not instantaneously. What is the reason behind that in the sense? Because we have the inductance and capacitance. We have both inductance and capacitance. So if we have inductance and capacitance, what the inductor will do? Inductor never allows the sudden changes in the current. And capacitor never allows the sudden change in voltage. So we will see in detail about that. And before going to that, just to take the notes. Let's write on the next line. The power system can be considered. The power system can be considered as made up of linear impedance elements. Linear impedance elements of resistance, inductance, and capacitance. Next slide. In such power system, the load is connected to the source, until a fault suddenly occurs. This fault is due to closing of the switch. Closing of the switch or switches in electrical circuit. The closing of the switch changes the circuit closing of the switch changes the circuit currents and voltages. Yes. This redistribution is this redistribution is accompanied in general by a transient period during which resultant currents and voltages may momentarily be relatively high. Yes, in some examinations, that is university question papers, they ask one question. Yes, in power systems, the redistribution of currents and voltages, electric current and voltage can take either instantaneously or gradually changes. So which one is right? Whether instantaneous, is it instantaneous or gradually? If it is not, then just you give the reasons. Just you keep studying the reasons for redistribution of currents and voltages redistribution of currents and voltages cannot take place instantaneously in power system. Yes, what are the reasons? Yes, the best reason is, the first one is, what is the first one? Because the power system contains the passive elements like resistor, inductor, capacitor. And the inductor does not allow the sudden change in current. That is instantaneous change in current. So why it does not change instantaneous change in current? If you see, what is voltage across inductor? V is equal to L di by dt. If suppose the current is changed, that is di is equal to I, without change in time, that is instantaneous change, is dt is equal to 0. Dt is equal to 0. Then what is voltage across inductor? V is equal to L into di by 0. So which is infinity? Which is infinity in the sense? What do you mean by infinite voltage? Infinite voltage corresponds to open circuit. Infinite voltage corresponds to open circuit. Actually, is it open circuit? No. Is it open circuit? No. And practically, infinite voltage is also not possible in the power system. Therefore, what we say, the energy stored by the inductor, that is electromagnetic energy stored by inductor, that is half Li square, is gradual. It is not instantaneous. It is gradual. It's right in the first part. Yes, the electromagnetic energy stored by an inductance is half Li square, where I is instantaneous value of current. Let's go to the next line. Let us assume inductance is constant. So inductance is constant in the sense the change in energy occurs due to the change in current only. Okay? Inductance is constant. And the magnitude energy requires change. The magnitude energy change. Magnitude energy requires change in current. Which an inductor is opposed by an EMF of magnitude. EMF of magnitude L di by dt. Next line. When the current changes instantaneously, that is di is equal to I, but dt is equal to 0. Then L di by dt is infinity, which is not possible practically. Therefore, the change of energy in an inductor, is gradual. Yes, this is in the point of inductor. Can we repeat the same in the point of capacitor? Yes, in the point of capacitor, what we say, the capacitor stores the energy in electric field. That is half CV square. So here also we assume C is constant. When C is constant, so in order to change the magnitude of energy, that is energy stored in the capacitor, that is electrical energy, the voltage has to be changed. the change in voltage either instantaneous or gradual. Yes, let us see that. It is not instantaneous, it is gradual only. Yes, why it is gradual, why it is not instantaneous in the sense? Because the current passing through the capacitor is I is equal to C into dV by dt. I is equal to C into dV by dt. If it is I is equal to C dV by dt, so for instantaneous change in voltage, that is instantaneous change in voltage in the sense dV is equal to V, but dt is equal to 0. Sudden change in voltage. Then what is current? I is equal to C into V by 0. This is infinity. That is infinite amount of current. Is it possible practically? No. Practically, it is not possible. Therefore, what we say? In the power system, the current cannot change instantaneously. But the current changes or the voltage changes gradually. Voltage changes gradually. Let's write on the next point. The electrostatic energy. Electrostatic energy stored by a capacitor. Stored by a capacitor capital C is half C V square, where V is the instantaneous value of voltage, where V is instantaneous value of voltage. So here also write the same statements. Let us assume the capacitance is to be constant. Hence, the change in energy requires change in voltage across capacitor. Change in voltage across capacitor. Yes, for capacitor. Let's write on this equation. I is equal to C into dV by dt. For sudden changes in voltage. Or for instantaneous change of voltage. For instantaneous change of voltage. Just write these three lines. That is dV is equal to V, dt is equal to 0, therefore I is equal to infinity. Yes, which is not possible practically. Therefore, the change in energy, in a capacitor is gradual. Yes. Yes, now you can observe that there are only two components, that is inductance and capacitance, in an electric circuit which stores energy. And we have seen that the change in energy through these components is gradual. Okay. And therefore, the redistribution of energy following a circuit change takes a finite time. The third component is also there. Yes, what is the third component? So that is the resistance which consumes the energy. At any time, the principle of conservation of energy in an electric circuit applies. The rate of energy generation is equal to rate of store of energy plus the rate of energy consumption. Rate of energy consumption. So therefore, what you say? In power system, there are three components are there. The third component is resistor. So if we apply the law of conservation of energy, at any time, the energy generated is equal to energy stored plus energy consumed. Energy generated is equal to energy stored plus energy consumption. Okay? Now you can see that there are simple facts. There are three simple facts are there. Yes, what is that? The current cannot change instantaneously through inductor. The voltage across a capacitor cannot change instantaneously. And law of conservation of energy must hold good. That is, these are the fundamentals to the phenomenon of transients in the electric power system. Yes, what are the fundamental to the phenomenon of transients in electric power system? That is, the current cannot change instantaneously through inductor. The voltage across capacitor cannot change instantaneously. And the law of conservation of energy must hold good. Yes, write in these three. Yes, note. Just write in note. Number one, the current cannot change instantaneously through an inductor. Next, second, the voltage across capacitor cannot change instantaneously. Third, the law of conservation of energy must hold good. The law of conservation of energy must hold good. Yes, what is the law of conservation of energy? Energy generated is equal to energy stored plus energy consume. This equation must satisfy the power system at any instant, at any time. Okay. So now what you observe from entire this introduction, what you observe? Yes, if suppose in order to get the transients, so who must present in the circuit or who must present in the system? that is either inductor or capacitor. Yes, either inductor or capacitor. Student, that from the above, it can be said that in order to have the transients in electrical system, the following requirement should be must. That is, the first one is either inductor or capacitor or both should be present in the system. And second one is a sudden change in the form of fault or any switching operation should take place. Okay, there are two components of voltage in power system during the transient period. Yes, what are those two in the sense? The first one is, fundamental frequency voltage, and second one is natural frequency voltage. And there is chance of getting the third component. The third component is known as harmonic voltage. The harmonic voltage, so which results from unbalanced currents flowing in the rotating machines. The third component is harmonic voltage. Resulting from unbalanced currents flowing in rotating machines. Okay, so when we have the harmonic voltage, whenever the unbalanced currents are flowing in rotating machines, so then we have the harmonic voltage. Then what do you mean by natural frequency voltages? Natural frequency voltages appear immediately after sudden occurrence of a fault. They simply added to the fundamental frequency voltages. Since the resulting voltages are greater importance from the practical point of view, it will be preferable to speak of the fundamental frequency or natural frequency components simply as a transient voltage. The transient voltages are affected by the number of connections and arrangements of the circuits. Okay, so let me stop here. This is introduction for the transients in power system. In the next class, we will see about the open circuit line and short circuit line. Okay. So stay home, stay safe. I hope all are All of you are doing good. Thank you for listening to the class.